Months of rumour and speculation all come to an end today as we return to Melbourne for the opening race of what promises to be an enthralling season. Welcome along then to the Australian Grand Prix. The Melbourne circuit is certainly one that needs to be taken seriously. Its combination of slippery surfaces and difficult corners make it a tricky track when it comes to overtakes. Drivers find it hard to pass and will need to take full advantage of those DRS zones if they want to have any hope of breaking through. Here we are then, Formula One in 2020. The fight for the World Championship all starts here today. Mercedes on the hunt for a seventh consecutive title. They'll have Ferrari and Red Bull to contend with along the way. Williams struggled to find their feet last year. They'll be hoping for a stronger start this time around. And what I wonder of the Renault-powered cars. Will they be able to step forward? Maybe even onto the podium on a regular basis. Plenty to discuss then with Anthony Davidson. He's out of hibernation too, and alongside me in the commentary box once again.
It's good to be back, Crofty. Let's hope for some good racing today. We can't know at this point how competitive these teams are relative to each other, but hopefully nobody is able to run and hide. We want to see these drivers pushing to the limit all the way to the checkered flag.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. The Flying Finn lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Albon, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Norris, Stroll, Ricciardo, Perez, and Max Verstappen, Gasly, Kvyat, Valtteri Bottas, and Ocon, Grosjean, Raikkonen, Kevin Magnussen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Russell, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
We're going to need you to push hard if we're going to get a good result today. Let's make it happen. That's a decent start. Good job. We'll be right back. as the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Spare energy, use your overtake button. The pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Window open. Let's box this lap. expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Work, that brings you up a place. Lando is in the pits. Lando in the pits. The car in front is 1.6 seconds. our teammate by 13.7 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Overtake and burn some of this energy. has 3 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Great job, you've done everything we wanted today.
Brilliant stuff from McLaren today. What a superb victory. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure, and no doubt they'll be celebrating tonight. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. The Flying Finn takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
It's got to be Valtteri Bottas, a commanding performance that I think had the audience's eyes glued to him for the majority of the race.
It's time to check out the Constructors' standings. McLaren supplant the previous leaders, taking control of the championship. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.